What time is it, my creatives? That's right. It's photo hacking time, and it's your host, Charlotte Telcedo. And today we're going to be creating fonts. And specifically, I had questions about people wanting to know how they can bring their Procreate fonts over into the Font Creator Pro that I have been using to create fonts. Now, there's a bunch of ways to do this. So first, I'm going to show you with Photoshop, but I do want to tell you about Procreate. You can draw out your font in Procreate and save it as a PSD and import it into Photoshop and then remove the background and then do it on your desktop, which I totally recommend as the step to do that. Now, specifically, it doesn't need to be any specific size as long as it's large enough in order to be vectorized and not get pixelated. All right, so my document right now is just at about 8.5 by 7 inches, okay? Now I'm gonna create a new layer by clicking the plus sign here. I wanted to tell you guys, I'm in the version of Photoshop. Let me go to help and system info. I'm actually in version 22 because I can't get rid of the 3D. And so I haven't upgraded. I refuse to upgrade. I'm not paying for 3D. When you've been giving me free 3D for like 20 fucking years of Photoshop, Adobe, I'm not gonna pay for it. So I'm stubborn. Anyways, so I digress. I also wanted to mention that my Wacom tablet is misbehaving and I have to like reset it. So I'm just gonna draw a janky letter and that's gonna be it. So we're just gonna call this layer letter A. Okay, so there we go. So you're gonna pick up your brush tool here. And I'm just using the default regular legacy brushes. Right here, it's this little circle, plain ass circle here. And if you don't have these brushes, they're the default legacy brushes in Photoshop. Go to legacy and just click on that bad boy. Now I have my smoothing at 31%. You can also change your angle. But like I said, we're just gonna draw just some random A here. All right, so I have my A here and there it is. It's not pretty, I know. I make chicken scratches. That's what I do. All right, so you're going to remove the background here, and then you're going to press Control T, select the layer, and now you can move it or modify it if you want. But I'm just gonna leave that ugly ass letter the way it is. Now we're gonna go over here to the crop tool, and we are going to press Shift and hold down the corners to just kind of like get a little rendition of that. Okay. Now, once you have your ugly letter, you're going to press File, Save As, okay? And you're going to save it on your computer as a ping, okay? And we're going to go to the next step. So I'm going to go to my desktop. All right, now you have your ugly ass letter saved to your desktop. You're going to just double click on Font Creator to open it up. It might take a second. This weird window is going to pop up here. All right, I need to get rid of that. No. I'm going to close that out. I'm going to go to File, New, create a new, my ugly ass letter. I'm going to create a new font, font family. Okay, press OK. So you're going to go over here in this dialog here, it's troubleshooting, and this is going to say incomplete letters. You're going to double click on the big A because I made a big A. And in between here and this letter, you're going to right click, okay, and then import image. And then you're going to select your ugly ass letter. There is my ugly ass letter. And it's gonna take a second to import. We'll wait. Still waiting. Okay. Now you're gonna have all these options to pop up. If you like the way that it is, I'm just gonna leave it to this so you can just look. I have it on smooth, trace, thresholds at 192, and then just click generate. Okay, so now you have your ugly ass letter in here, and then you can just click on the sliders here to just position it into here. There's some little rules with typography. Oh. And sometimes the pieces will pop out, so you have to make sure you have it all selected so you can move it around. So once you have it in here, you can save your letter, of course. You can save the project, but you have to go back in here and you have to fill out all these letters and the glyphs and stuff like that. So this is kind of like your workstation. All right, so we're done here. I'm gonna close out my ugly ass letter. I'm not gonna save it because I don't want to. I'm gonna show you another thing in Photoshop where you can save a whole fucking alphabet. How cool is that? So I got this alphabet from Creative Market. Now, I don't recommend doing this because this is illegal, But what you could do is you can go in here and save these previews. You can screenshot them, and then you can save them as a whole alphabet, and then you can vectorize them. But that's illegal. I'm just doing this for instructional purposes. Okay, once you're in Illustrator, you're going to go File, New. It doesn't matter because we're not going to be all that. And now we're going to open the image that I have on my desktop. It's just a picture of a font. So to do that, you're going to go to File, Open, up here at the tippy top. And of course, Illustrator sometimes has issues. Okay, there's my font. All right, so I have my whole alphabet here. So what we're going to do is go to Image Trace. If you don't see Image Trace, you go to Window, Image Trace. Okay, it's right there. All right, so select it to affect it. Go to Image Trace. All right, and this is the Image Trace dialog box. Okay, so it's set to the default, but you can try different ones. I like the black and white logo. Of course, you're going to probably want to go with silhouette. It takes the background automatically. But black and white logo sometimes has a better, you know, it looks better. So you can just press ignore white and it will take out the white. All right. And then you could bump up the threshold a little bit and it looks pretty good. I'm going to take down the noise a little bit. It's not going to be perfect because we copied this and it just is what it is. So press expand. All right. So we have it expanded, and now what we have to do is we have to go to Object and Group, so all of these are separated. And of course, they're not truly separated all the way. Some of these will be stuck together. And as you can see, it's not the most perfect of font. I'm just doing this for instructional purposes. Of course, you could possibly trace over this and clean this up. That's what a professional would do, but I am by far not a professional. I am fucked up. All right, so you're going to get your eraser tool out here. I'm pretty sure that there's other ways to cut this open, but I'm lazy and I like to do things fast and dangerous. So press the shift key down with your eraser tool and just go right down the middle and separate those two little holes. All right, so you're going to select it all, go to Object and Group. You're going to want to group all of these because sometimes these will have raggedy, you know, pieces that are just, you know, I don't know. Sometimes they're not like fully formed. So just go and Object and Group. Do that with all of them. All right. So once you have that, I'm going to go back to my desktop because I already have mine. And I'm going to go back to the font creator and double click to open it up. All right. I'm going to close that out. I'm going to create a new font, new Jenky font. I'm going to call it new Jenky font. And you could do true type or PostScript, however you want. It doesn't matter. Press OK. All right, so I'm going to my incomplete characters. Now I'm going to go to my lowercase, double click on it. And now I'm going to open that font the same way I did the other one. And then I'm going to import an image. Now, if you want to draw a contour, you can. You can add a composite glyph member. You can do all kinds of stuff. You can add like existing things in here. There's all kinds of stuff. You really need to play with this because this is a fun software. I'm telling you guys. All right. So I'm going to import the image. You can import the image, but you can also drag it over there. There you go. So you can drag it in there and it will be in there like that without having to like re-vectorize it, so to speak. So now you can resize it and put it to where you want to. And so that's pretty much it. So now I want to show you guys another cool trick with this font creator. You can create fonts from existing fonts. Oh my God, this is so amazing. So let's go ahead and get into it. So let's go ahead and close this out. I'm not going to save it. Wait a minute. I didn't close it out. One thing about this software is that it sometimes will keep the item in there even if you didn't close it, but this time it didn't. All right, so what I want to do is I want this font here. I want to modify it and make a new font from an existing font that's already been created. Say you have a font that you found in the public domain and you want to rehash it or redo it or put a little spin on it. You can do that. You can't do that with other people's shit though. I'm just letting you know. All right, so how to do this, you're going to go to File, not New, this time. not open installed font, which is what I had originally thought, but you're going to want to select open. And then you're going to want to scroll out to the font that you want to open. So I'm opening this goth font that kind of looks like Taylor Swift's Reputation font. So it's going to take a few seconds to open it up. All right. So just like the other fonts, you can go in here and you can add stuff. You can draw over it. You can make new stuff. Or you could just come in here and rename it. If it's a public domain font, you can just kind of take over it. So you can call it Taylor Swift's Reputation. Reputation. You can change everything in here. All of this stuff. And then once you get done, you can save it. So that's the cool thing about that. There's all different kinds. You can add different metrics. You can calculate. You can do pretty much anything's the limit here. You also have over here where you can change glyph properties. You can add onto the font. And then once you're done, you can export the font into a whole bunch of different ones. You can also create SVG fonts and colored fonts. And you can do a lot with this software. So I hope that you guys like this tutorial. I hope it was beneficial. I hope it's a little bit more explanatory than the last time. Like I said, like I tried to, explain this as fast and quickly as I can. But as with any software, it's going to be a little bit complicated. And the only way that you're going to learn it is if you practice in it. So thanks so much for watching, guys. If you like this tutorial, please like and give it a big thumbs up. Thank you so much. Don't forget to subscribe.